At first glance, what would come to your mind when you saw such a scene on the ground? Fruit pulp piled up on top of each other, rotten peels and orange leftovers covered in flies. You would probably say environmental pollution, waste of waste, or something went wrong. You might even go a little further and think that nature is being harmed. It may come to mind that such uncontrolled dumping could destroy the ecosystem. But leave all these impressions aside. What you are about to hear will show you that nature is much more powerful and even healing than we think, because behind these images lies an event that is impressive enough to go down in world history. Almost unbelievable. Yes, a huge natural miracle took place with just orange peels, and without any technological devices, chemicals, or million-dollar budgets. And this event did not attract anyone's attention for exactly 20 years, until scientists returned to the same place years later and looked at it again, until they witnessed the incredible transformation that was before their eyes. Now we will dive into the backstage of this story together, but let me warn you, what I'm going to tell you is much more than the environmental projects you know, and to understand the true size of the story, you will need to be patient, think, and be ready to be surprised. The calendars show the year 1997. We are going to Costa Rica, a small but incredibly biodiverse country in Central America. A project that will change the future of nature was being launched there. Meet Daniel Jansen and Winnie Hallwalks, ecologists from Princeton University. Two researchers who have been searching for solutions to the destruction of tropical forests for years, wanting to go beyond traditional methods. Many people know Costa Rica for its tropical forests. However, due to years of logging, agricultural expansion, and fires, many forest areas had dried out. In addition, the soil had become infertile and could not renew itself. At this point, Jansen and Hallwalks made a rather striking, even a little crazy suggestion for the time. They contacted Del Oro, one of the largest fruit juice producers in the region. They proposed that thousands of tons of waste from orange production be dumped directly into the forest area. Yes, it sounds a little strange, doesn't it? But think about it. This waste was already going to waste. Pulp, shell, fiber, 100% organic and chemical-free. Instead of harming nature, could this material help revive the soil? They decided to try it. And what happened next was the beginning of a story the scientific world will never forget. Towards the end of 1997, giant trucks began to approach the area. The Del Oro company began to transport a total of 12,000 tons of orange waste to an area of approximately 3 hectares on the forest border. This thick, orange, dense, and sticky layer that accumulated on the surface soon began to attract attention. Some environmentalists and locals seriously opposed this practice. Are you dumping garbage into nature? This is destroying the ecosystem. Since when has orange peel been an environmental solution? But scientists were patient. They would observe the results of this waste for years to gauge nature's response. The first few weeks passed, then a few months. The peels began to rot, insects and fungi settled on them. Soon, weeds began to grow in some areas, but nothing remarkable happened. As time went by, scientists turned to other projects and the area fell out of favor. But the soil was working quietly at that time. In 2013, 16 years after the first dumps, the scientists decided to revisit the area. But the problem was that the dumping area was not clearly marked. The terrain had changed so much that it was almost impossible to find the original orange waste dump. Because they saw a completely different landscape, the once dry, bare, barren ground was now covered with greenery. The trees had grown many meters tall, a dense vegetation had formed, and a humid microclimate had emerged. And right next to it, the control area, which had not been disturbed at all, was still the same. Dry, barren, and with very little sign of life. When the scientists began to compare the two areas, they were shocked by the differences they saw. But how could orange peels alone have caused such a transformation? Detailed analyses were initiated, soil samples were taken, and their nutritional values, carbon content, and microorganism density were examined one by one. The results clearly demonstrated how successful this experiment was. In the soil where orange waste was poured, the carbon content had almost doubled. This showed how much the soil had been enriched in terms of organic matter. Plant diversity had tripled, and even new tree species had begun to sprout spontaneously in the region. In addition, the insect population, earthworms, and fungi had all increased incredibly. The upper layer of the soil was absorbing and holding water like a living sponge thanks to the richness left by the rotting orange peels. Only a small touch had been made to nature, and that too with a completely natural waste. But the effect had been a huge transformation. After this incident, scientists began to rethink the concept of ecological restoration. Are we being too complicated when trying to repair nature? Perhaps nature wants simplicity, not complexity. Orange peels were just one example. Other organic wastes that could have a similar effect are being thrown away in the world in millions of tons, and most of this waste is either burned, buried in landfills, or used for energy production. However, when left in the right place and in the right amount, this waste can actually fuel the rebirth of nature. After this incident, many environmental groups in Costa Rica started campaigns for similar projects. But unfortunately, bureaucratic obstacles and legal restrictions made it difficult to spread worldwide. Today, that area in Costa Rica where orange peels were shed continues to live as a lush forest. Perhaps this incident reminds us that the most effective way to save nature is not through technology, but through simple solutions within nature itself. Perhaps we don't need new inventions to solve some problems, but just a little common sense and courage. Now I ask you, the next time you throw away a fruit peel, how about imagining what it could turn into in nature? Because sometimes a tiny peel can start a huge forest. And who knows? Maybe what will save nature is exactly what we throw away. Sometimes science progresses not through complex machines and laboratories, but by listening to the way nature works. This story shows exactly that. All we have to do is observe nature and understand what it needs. The rest will happen on its own. This is not just the story of orange peels. This is also the answer to the question, what can happen if the right idea is left in the right place at the right time? And perhaps the question we should be asking is, who will build the world of the future? The grand engineering projects or the small shell thrown into the ground?